गुड इवनिंग क्लास. दिस इज माई थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन डिस्क्रिप्टिव पैराग्राफ्स, वेयर इन टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट डिस्क्राइबिंग अ थिंग और एन ऑब्जेक्ट. इन माई अर्लियर लेक्चर्स आई हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट हाउ टू डिस्क्राइब अ पर्सन और हाउ टू डिस्क्राइब अ प्लेस. सो वेन यू आर डिस्क्राइबिंग अ थिंग और एन ऑब्जेक्ट, दीज आर द थ्री थिंग्स दैट यू मस्ट कीप इन माइंड. यू कैन बिगिन बाई डिस्क्राइबिंग वॉट काइंड ऑफ अ डिवाइस इट इज, इट्स पार्ट्स such as a see-through glass door or a screen, its function and usefulness. That is, for example, if you are describing an oven, you can begin by talking about what kind of device it is. So it's an electrical device, we all know that. So it's an electric device, this is something that you can start with. Then you have to move towards its parts. So when you are talking about its parts, you can say that it has got a see-through glass door. And when you talk about its function or usefulness, you can talk about things like it is used for toasting bread, it is used for baking cakes, for grilling sandwiches, and for heating food in general. So this is the order that you are expected to follow when you are describing a thing. And if you are not writing it in this order, at least you should include these three important things when you are describing an object or a thing. Next class, when you are describing a thing, the most important thing that is expected from you is you should have an eye for detail. By this, what I mean by saying this is that you need to be a good observer. So if you are asked to describe a thing, try to recall it. Go in for the minute details that are there. Don't make it very boring. But at the same time, these three important aspects must be covered when you are describing a thing or an object. The next thing is, when you are describing a thing or an object, you should make use of simple present tense. For example, I told you, when you are describing an oven, so it is an electric device, so you are making use of simple present tense, it is. Or the oven is a device used for baking, grilling, heating. So look at the structure, the oven is a device, or it has a see-through door. So it has, the oven is an electric device, or oven is used for baking. So all these structures tell us that we should make use of simple present tense. But at the same time, if you are talking about an object that you have used in the past, for example, you may have used a particular cell phone in the past, you may make use of simple past tense as well. So here I'll read out the description of a cell phone, and that will help you understand how you should go with it. So I'm currently using an Apple iPhone 4S, which is a smartphone to say the least. Unlike other cell phones, the 4S functions on a micro SIM. It has an internal memory of 32 GB and exhibits camera clarity of 8 megapixels. My phone is updated with the latest applications, videos and movies that hold my interest. It also has a number of instant messaging and social networking sites that keeps me occupied and amused throughout the day. Many a times I use it to make Skype calls to my sister in the US. I am also a game geek, and so my phone has an entire bank of games that one could choose from. Lastly, I would like to mention that I share a close relationship with my phone and feel incomplete without it. So today class, if I ask you to describe your cell phone, the last line that you can add to it is, today your cell phone contains your entire university. Yes, we cannot do without our cell phones at the present crisis that we have found ourselves in. When you closely look at this paragraph that describes a cell phone, you will notice that the opening line tells you what kind of device it is. And then it tells you that it's a gadget, and then it moves on to talk about the various parts that it has. So the kind of camera that it has, the kind of screen or the kind of SIM that it uses. Then it moves on to the functions and usefulness that is associated with the cell phone. And at the same time, though the writer is telling us giving us minute details at certain places, but at the same time, he or she hasn't made it too boring. Rather, it's amusing for us to read it. So this is the way you are expected to describe a cell phone. Now, with this class, I come to the end of my lecture on describing things. Or the earlier lectures talked about describing places and describing persons. So let's in totality today talk about what is the function that descriptive paragraphs serve together. So description is used both in fiction and non-fiction. This is something that we can conclude. I've given you examples from both fiction and non-fiction. It helps to beautify the style of writing, establish settings. So when we are describing a place, we basically, the writer established the setting of a place by describing the place. Helps one to draw a picture of characters in a fictional piece. So describing a person, by describing a person, the writer is giving you a picture of a character in a fictional piece. It gives detailed information and helps in identification in a non-fictional piece. For example, identifying a wanted person, or somebody may have used a car to kidnap somebody and you are asked to describe the car. So when you are describing a car, what basically you are doing is you are describing an object. This uses describing words, that is adjectives, to serve its purpose. And when I was talking about describing persons and places and things, I have told you how adjectives play a very important role. In fact, at certain places, I have also given you a list of verbal inputs. So with this class, a set of vocabularies. So with this class, I'm going to end my lecture. In my next lecture, I'll begin with a fresh topic. Thank you. Thank you so much.